alkylbenzenes bearing at least one hydrogen on the benzylic position can be brominated with bromine and heat or light. And this process is known as benzylic bromination. Alternatively, NBS, or N-bromosuccinamide, can be used as a source of a steady, small concentration of bromine. The mechanism entails a radical chain reaction. If bromine is used for this reaction, heat or light initiates the homolysis of a small number of Br2 molecules, and this generates a small number of bromine radicals. Then, in the first propagation step, a bromine radical abstracts a hydrogen atom from the benzylic position, and this leads to the formation of a carbon-centered radical as well as HBr. The hydrogen atom is abstracted specifically from the benzylic position because of the significant resonance delocalization that a benzylic radical has. That radical can be delocalized onto three of the ring carbons, and this provides a significant amount of stabilization. During the second propagation step, the benzylic radical abstracts a halogen from an unreacted molecule of Br2. This produces the product along with a new bromine radical. And this process is a chain reaction because the bromine radical formed during the second propagation step can enter into a new cycle of propagation. Termination steps are steps in which any two radicals combine with one another. And these termination steps explain the fate of the few remaining radicals left over once the reaction has neared completion. However, the vast majority of product is formed during propagation step 2. Therefore, the termination steps are not shown here. As we noted in the reaction overview, NBS and light can be used as alternative conditions for benzylic bromination. The mechanism for this process is extremely similar to that presented in the video on the allylic bromination of alkenes, so you may find it useful to review that video. Let's turn our attention to a specific example. Propylbenzene can be brominated in the benzylic position using bromine along with heat or light to initiate the reaction. The mechanism begins with the homolysis of bromine during the initiation step. But it's important to remember that only a few molecules of bromine will homolyze to make just a few bromine radicals. In propagation step 1, a bromine radical then abstracts a hydrogen atom specifically from the benzylic position because the benzylic radical is the most stable radical possible for this substrate. Note that the byproduct, HBr, is also produced during this step. Finally, in propagation step 2, the carbon-centered radical abstracts a halogen from an unreacted molecule of bromine. This yields not only the product, but also a new bromine radical that can be used in another round of propagation steps. In summary, benzylic bromination enables the functionalization of an alkylbenzene having at least one benzylic hydrogen. Using bromine and heat or light, or alternatively, NBS and light, a bromine is installed at the benzylic carbon via a radical chain reaction. The resultant halide can undergo further reactions such as substitution or elimination if desired. The preceding was an excerpt from the book Introductory Organic Reaction Mechanisms, a color-coded approach to arrow pushing. If you found this video to be helpful, you may be interested in the complete book, which is available in ebook format from Scribd, in paperback from Amazon, or in paperback at a discounted price from Lulu.